friends and welcome. Today we'll see the topic transformation to polar coordinates. If you observe that in the integral you have the terms of x square, y square or x square plus y square bracket square. These types of terms are there. Then in that case we use the transformation to polar coordinate. We know the relation x is equal to r cos theta, y is equal to r sin theta. Dx dy is r dr d theta. We'll replace x square plus y square by r square. Now I'll take one example based on this. Evaluate double integral of x square y square upon x square plus y square dx dy over the region bounded by x square plus y square is equal to 4 and x square plus y square is equal to 9. If you observe this, this is nothing but circle with center at origin. Now if I draw a circle, first one is circle with center at origin and radius is equal to 2. Second one is also a circle with center at origin and radius is equal to 3. And we want the area, we want to evaluate this integral over this region which is common to both this circle, which is included between these two circles. Now if I will consider the radial vector, we will observe that r varies from this point to this point and at this point r is equal to 2. Therefore the limits for r are 2 to 3 and theta varies from, for complete annulus theta will varies from 0 to 2 pi. So 0 to 2 pi. If I substitute this value, you will get I is equal to integration from 0 to 2 pi. Second integral is from 2 to 3. X square is r square cos square theta. Y square, that is r square sin square theta upon x square plus y square is r square into dx dy. Dx dy is r dr d theta. If I substitute these values, this r square will get cancelled. R square into r is r cube. Integral of r cube is r raised to 4 upon 4. Limits from 2 to 3 into integration from 0 to 2 pi. What is remaining? Sin square theta, cos square theta, d theta. If you apply limits, upper limit minus lower limits, you will get 3 raised to 4 minus 2 raised to 4 upon 4. This sin square theta, cos square theta is an even function. So we can use the additional result, that instead of 0 to 2 pi, we can round down 4 times 0 to pi by 2. Sin square theta, cos square theta, d theta. And for this, we will apply reduction formula. 3 raised to 4 is 81. 2 raised to 4 is 16. If I apply reduction formula, 2 minus 1, that is 1. Similarly, 2 minus 1, 1. Upon 2 plus 2, 4. Reduced by 2 into pi by 2. So, you will get the answer 65 pi upon 4 into 2, 8. 8 into 2, 16. 65 pi by 16. Now, I will take one more example. Now, I will take the second example. Say, integration from 0 to a upon root 2 by 2 under root of a square minus y square log of x square plus y square dx dy. Again, if you observe, we have the term of x square plus y square. So, we will transfer this to polar coordinate. These are limits in terms of y. That means these are limits for x. That is, x is equal to y. Second is, x is equal to under root of a square minus y square. That is, x square plus y square is equal to a square. This represents a circle with center at origin, radius is equal to a. And these are limits for y. That is, y is equal to 0 to y is equal to a upon root 2. If I draw a circle with center at origin, radius is equal to a. This is circle with center at origin, radius is equal to a. And x is equal to y, that is the line passing through origin, x is equal to y. So this is the region of integration. They are considering horizontal strip. You can check the limits if you want. If I consider the horizontal strip, x varies from y to this circle, that is y to under root of a square minus y square. So this is the region of integration. Now if I consider the radial vector, you will get the limits for r, that r varies from 0 to this circle. On this circle you have r is equal to a. So r will varies from 0 to a, and theta varies from 0 to, we know that the line x is equal to y makes an angle pi by 4. So theta will varies from 0 to pi by 4. That is I is equal to integration from 0 to a. Second integral is from 0 to pi by 4. Log of x square plus y square is r square. Dx dy is r dr d theta. Now if I integrate this with respect to theta first, integral of d theta is theta. Limits from 0 to pi by 4. This integral as it is, r varies from 0 to a. Log of r square into r dr. If you apply limits for the first bracket, you will get pi by 4. Integration from 0 to a, log of r square into r dr. For this, if I use the substitution, say r square is equal to t, this will implies 2r dr is equal to dt. That is r dr is equal to dt upon 2. And whenever we are using substitution, we have to check the limits. In this case, r varies from 0 to a. So t will varies from 0 to a square. If I use this substitution, you will get pi by 4. Integration from 0 to a square log t into dt upon 2. Now we know how to take the integral of logarithmic function. We'll multiply by 1 and then we'll apply by parts. I can take this half outside. We'll get 5 by 8 in bracket. Logarithmic is first function and 1 will be second function. If I apply by parts, first function as it is, that is log t as it is, integral of 1, that is t, minus in the integral sign, derivative of log t, that is 1 upon t, into integral of 1, that is t dt. This t will get cancelled. So you have pi by 8. Limits is 0 to a square. Pi by 8 in bracket t log t minus integral of dt is t. Limits from 0 to a square. If you apply limits, you will get pi by 8 in bracket a square log of a square minus a square. No need to apply lower limit because lower limit is 0. You will get the answer 0. So this is the integration of this. Now we'll take the third example. We'll take one more example. Double integral of y square dx dy over the region R, where r is x square plus y square equal to ax. Second one is x square plus y square is equal to twice x. Both these are circle. First we'll try to write down their standard form. If I make the perfect square, say x square minus ax plus a square by 4 plus y square is equal to a square by 4. Both this side a square by 4 will get cancelled. There will be no change. This is x minus a by 2 bracket square plus y minus 0 bracket square equal to a by 2 bracket square. So this represents a circle with center at a by 2 comma 0 and radius is equal to a by 2. Equation of this circle in polar form is r is equal to a cos theta. Simply have to put x square plus y square as r square and x is equal to r cos theta. Similarly, for this, if I find it is x square minus twice ax plus a square plus y square equal to a square. This is perfect square of x minus a bracket square plus y minus 0 bracket square equal to a square. So this represents a circle with center at a comma 0 and radius is equal to a. And equation of this circle in polar form is r is equal to 2a cos theta. If I try to draw the figure, say one is the circle with center at a by 2 comma 0 and another one is circle with center at a comma 0. And we want to evaluate the integral over this part. We can say the complete integral is 2 times of this much of part. And if I consider the radial vector, it will varies from inner circle to outer circle. Equation of inner circle is r is equal to a cos theta and equation of outer circle is r is equal to 2a cos theta. Therefore, we have the limits r varies from a cos theta to 2a cos theta and theta will varies from 0 to pi by 2 if you consider symmetry. So your integral I is equal to 2 times integration from 0 to pi by 2 r varies from a cos theta to 2a cos theta. Y square is r square sin square theta. Dx dy is r dr d theta and that is equal to 2 times integration from 0 to pi by 2 r square into r is r cube. Integral of r cube is r s to 4 upon 4 limits from a cos theta to 2a cos theta sin square theta d theta. Now if you apply limits for this, you will get 1 by 2 integration from 0 to pi by 2 2a raised to 4, that is 16a raised to 4 cos raised to 4 theta minus a raised to 4 cos raised to 4 theta into sin square theta d theta, that is equal to 1 by 2 integration from 0 to pi by 2 16a raised to 4 cos raised to 4 theta minus this will become 15a raised to 4 cos raised to 4 theta sin square theta d theta. And for this, if I apply reduction formula, you have 15a raised to 4 upon 2 into 4 minus 1, that is 3 into 1, 2 minus 1 is 1 upon 4 plus 2, 6, decrease by 2, 6, 4, 2, both are even, therefore into pi by 2. We are using the reduction formula for cos raised to 4 theta sin square theta, that is 15 a raised to 4 pi upon 2 into 2 4, 4 into 4 16, 16 into 2 32, 32 into 2 is 64. So this is your answer. Thank you.